G'day there everyone, welcome to Temporal Paradox 1. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create and render a 720p or 1080p HD video suitable for upload to YouTube. And I'll be using the new Sony Vegas Pro 11. With the release of Sony Vegas Pro 11, the rendering windows have changed considerably, and even some of the default templates which were available in version 10 have now changed. Also, there's now GPU acceleration attached to the program, which basically means that the program can now take more advantage of the processing power of your graphics card to help speed up your rendering times and also improve the playback quality in the preview screen. So the very first thing you should do the first time you after you've installed the program is to go into Options, Preferences, Video tab, and on that third level there, open it up and make sure if your graphics card is compatible with this accelerated processing, it'll be listed there. So if it is, make sure you select it, apply it, and OK. If your graphics card doesn't appear on that list, it just says off, then it means your graphics card is a little bit too old, and so you'll probably have to update it if you want to use that, if you want to use it to speed up your rendering. So what's the next thing? Actually, before I go on any further, I just will warn you, this tutorial is going to be a hamburger of the lot. Instead of just doing a real quick thing that just breezes over things, I want to explain things fully to you and give you all the options that I think are the best options for rendering HD video. So next step, always set your project properties, very important. Open this up here. So for 720p, it's pretty easy because there's already templates in here which you can use without really changing at all. If you're shooting NTSC video, say in the United States, then 720-30p is going to be the setting for you. If you're in a PAL country shooting at 25 frames per second, that'll be the one for you. There's also one there for cinema style, 24p. And there's increasingly more people using DSLR cameras to shoot video, so you might be shooting at a higher frame rate. So you got that one there or that one there. Now I'll just select that 30p as my example. And so everything there is all good. The only thing that which you should probably change or make sure that the resolution quality is always set the best, and on the audio tab, make sure that your sample rate is always at 48 Hz, that's DVD quality, and that's set to best as well. Most 720p video is shot in true progressive, so you probably by default, it'll probably say none, so you can leave it in that setting there. It's only if your video was shot in interlaced style that you need to do the blend fields, but I'll leave it at none. So that's pretty easy for 720p. For 1080p, so you've got to do a few extra steps. You've got two templates here you can start off with. -60i, that's for NTSC users. -50i, that's PAL users. 60i, select that. First thing you've got to do is change the field order to progressive scan. You know, because all video shown over the internet on computers is always progressive scan. Just remember that, makes the life a lot easier. Once again, best deinterlace method. This time, make sure it's definitely blend fields, because you know most cameras in the universe are still shooting 1080 in interlaced. Audio, make sure that's best too, once again. And for any template, for doing absolutely any setting in Sony Vegas Pro, select that is probably a pretty good idea, because when you tick that little box, that quite often can get rid of those little black annoying strips that can appear at the side of your videos. Now I already made up an actual template for this 1080p, so it's come up there. So by default that won't be there, so you can just type in your own little template name and then press save it. Okay, and do that for 25p as well. Okie dokie, so now we'll actually put some video onto the timeline. Now I noticed another little thing on other people's YouTube videos, they're teaching some weird stuff. You don't import media into the program by clicking open. That's for opening up projects, not for importing movies. You press that little icon there. That's the safer way to do things. Another little tip while I'm going here is if when you click on top of your media, if you're unsure of the frame rate, click on top, the setting, all the properties are listed just here, okay? Okay, now we'll get into the juicy bit, the rendering. So I'll go render as. Just close this up a bit. Now this looks considerably different to Vegas Pro 10, Vegas Pro 9, but it's really not that difficult to work it out. Basically what they've done is added these filtering options. So if you're in the dark, you can press that and narrow down the field of templates that would be obvious to use. But you don't have to worry about that because I'm going to point you in the right direction. Traditionally speaking, for making video for YouTube, two best codecs to use is Sony AVC or Windows Media Video. But with the release of Pro 11, Sony's done something strange. I don't know whether they're smoking different dope or what they're doing, but they've got rid of all the internet templates, which used to be for Sony AVC. I still can't understand why. It's pretty strange. I'm going to show you at the end of the video how to get them back, if you still have version 10 or version 9 installed. So I'll come back that into one moment. What they've actually done is they've beefed up main concept. And that used to just have these silly little iPod templates, but now this is where you'll find your internet templates, okay? So for 720p, select that. Oh, another thing I should mention is this main concept rendering using GPU acceleration will give you the fastest rendering times of all. It's absolutely blazing fast. So for 720p, select that, then go customize template. That's all cool. One thing I think is a good idea to do is to deselect that, okay, because it can cause trouble sometime. Make sure your frame rate does match your project properties. The only thing you may like to change is the actual the bitrate settings down here. I think the settings they've got there are pretty good for YouTube. If you want to get your file size smaller, obviously reduce these numbers. For 720p, you could probably reduce the average bitrate down to 5 and maybe reduce the maximum down to 10. But that's up to you to do experimentation. Go to the audio tab, bitrate. I always think it's a good idea not to go below 192 kilobits per second when you're doing HD video. Otherwise, your audio will start sounding crap on YouTube because they're going to compress it once you upload it. You can go high if you like. It's up to you. You do your own experiments. Go back to video system. That just tells you if your graphics card is compatible. Project, we got all our settings right, so you don't have to change that. Last thing, most important thing, especially for Pro 11 users, is you got these options here. I actually suggest not to use automatic mode, but to do this. Do an experiment rendering using the CPU only, and also do a separate experiment using the GPU only. If you've got a really good graphics card or even two graphics cards installed, you will find that the GPU solution, which is the one I normally use, is absolutely mind-blowingly fast to render. So that's probably the best one to start off with. It's pretty easy, all that stuff there. Once you're happy with that, if you've made any changes here, you can just change your description at the top here and click save, but I haven't changed anything really. So I'm just going to press OK and then I'll get straight into rendering. Now for 1080p, it's exactly what I just showed you. Do 1080p, customize the template, and do all the same things. That's a pretty high bitrate setting there, so you may want to reduce that since if you're making a YouTube video. But once again, I'll leave it up to you to do some experimentation. So that's my concept. That's obviously what they're encouraging you to use today. One of my old favourites, because the file size is always a little bit smaller, was Windows Media Video. So if you want to use that as a solution, you've got some obvious choices here. So if you're doing 30p, I'll select that. Still do a customise. Audio, that's good setting. Video, just go through all this. Yep, that's all sweet. Bitrate. do your own experiment. 6 is pretty good. The rest you don't need to change. You can click OK and get cracking. That's a good setting. Doing 1080p. Have to be a little bit careful when you press 1080 because it by default it does this silly 1440 by 1080. You want to make sure that's your original frame size. Oh, hang on. Keep original frame size 1920 by 1080. But now we've also got to change the pixel aspect ratio to 1. That's very, very important. Bitrate, yeah, that's pretty cool. And you can change this, you know, relabel this if you want. I'll just put this, you know, Dex, just to let me know that I made a little change there. And you can click save, okay, and then render it. Okay, so the third method you could use if you really wanted to is Sony AVC. Sony AVC was traditionally in version 10 and version 9 the method that you would use that actually had inbuilt templates for doing uploads to the internet. But in version 11 they've removed those templates. If you have version 10, version 9 installed and you created extra templates in Sony AVC, they will carry forward. But if you're brand new to Sony Vegas, then I'll show you how to use Sony AVC if you really want to. You've got to do a little bit of a trick. So I'll open that up and start off with just one of these memory sticks here, okay? So just use the top one there, that'll do. Customize the template. First thing to do is change the format, video format to AVC. Then select the frame size. So if you're doing a 720p video, that's it there. Or if you're doing a 1080p, use that one there. I'll pretend I'm doing 1080p for this example. Then make that baseline and change that to CAVLC. Make sure your frame rate matches your project properties. Progressive scan, that's cool. Then do your bit rate. I reckon 10 megabits per second is pretty good for YouTube, but you could go a lot lower than that. I'll leave that up to you to do experiments, as I've been continually saying. Let's quickly go to the audio tab. Continue what I've been saying with other ones, where I think it's always good to increase the kilobits. 192 minimum in my book. You can go higher if you like. System, that's all cool. Project, of course we set our project properties at the beginning to best. They don't have to be changed. Go back to video. Final thing is encode mode once again. If you've got a really good modern GPU, select that. Or you may have to go for CPU if your GPU is pretty average. But do experiment between the both, then you'll find out. So I'll do GPU. Now I'll rename this template because it's definitely not a memory stick anymore. So I'll call this 1080-30p. 10 megabits per second, and my audio was 192 kilobits per second. Press that save, so it's there for next time. That means it's now in the list. Press OK, and then I can render. Oops, yeah, I've already done. And as you can see there, look how it's rendering extremely fast. Very, very fast indeed. So this is the advantage of the GPU acceleration. So that's it.
Oh dear, I just realized I forgot something that I promised. And that was, how do you import any templates that used to be in version 10 that are now missing from version 11? Well, it's very, very easy to do. What you've got to do is, this is what I would suggest to do, is actually totally close down version 11, okay? Make sure that's turned off. Boot up Vegas Pro 10. Now I'm going to have to import something lame just so I can get to the rendering engine. Go to render as. Now, where they got rid of templates for, I don't know why, was in the Sony AVC. So click that. And then, where are we here? I'll show you where they were. It's, there we go. There's all the templates I got rid of. Ridiculous. All those ones there. Okay, they're not in Pro 11. But there's a very easy way to do it. And that is just simply create these as custom templates, save them, then reopen up Pro 11 and they'll all appear. So how do you do that? Well, what I did was this. This is my little trick. All I did, I went into one at a time. So let's pick this one here. I went into that, clicked customize, and then just added, I just added an, actually added an asterisk at the beginning. Okay, I've already done that. So I'll do two asterisks. I'll press save. So that's saving the template. Okay, and then I'll just cancel out of all this crap. So I can turn Vegas Pro 10 now off. Okay, that's booted back up. Open up my project. Go to render as. Now, we're in the Sony AVC template, so let's look for the double asterisks. Yay! There you go. So if you do that, you can import in all those default pre-made templates that used to be in there, and they'll now appear in version 11. So that's my last little tip. Now you probably all need to have a little lie down after all that to take it all in. So thanks for watching. See you next time.